Hello, you guys, and welcome to Books by Brit TV. I'm your host, Brit, and today we are going to be doing my top movies that were based on a book or a magazine article, and it's going to be in no particular order, but I chose them not on how much of the book they put into the movie, but really based on how true to the story and the characters that the movies were based on the books. However, there is one exception where I will say that, you know, they kind of completely changed the character around for the movie, but it made the movie so much better. Yeah, it made the character so much better overall, how they redid him in the movie. All right, so in no particular order, let's just get started. And let's go ahead and get started. So the first is 2013's Dallas Buyers Club featuring Matthew McConaughey. Now, I read this, so the Dallas Buyers Club is about this man who's diagnosed with HIV, and he finds out about a retroviral that's available in Mexico, but not available for, it hasn't been approved by the FDA in America yet. So he goes to America, he makes trips to Mexico to smuggle the drug back into the country to give to other patients who are suffering from HIV/AIDS. And this is like in the late 80s, early 90s, you know, when we didn't have that much information about the HIV/AIDS disease. And the movie is actually based on an article that I read from the Dallas Morning News in 1992. I didn't write down a man who wrote it. But I read the article when, in my personal life, I'm a healthcare professional. And I took a disease intervention class where we were taught about HIV or whatever. And that's where I first read the article at. So it was really interesting to see how they based the movie, basically based upon that article. And they did a really fine job sticking true to the article as well as like being true to the actual story of the guy. I didn't write down his name. I forgot his name. Sorry. Number two, American Gangster starring Denzel Washington and Russell Crowe, 2007. Now, of course, we know that American Gangster is about the story of Frank Lucas, a drug kingpin active in the 60s and 70s in New York, who's out of, even though he originated in the Carolinas. All right, and the movie is actually based on an article that was printed in New York Magazine in 2000 that talked about the lawyer who represented Frank Lucas, you know, even though he was originally the prosecutor or the investigator who arrested him and everything like that. The article is about him. Now, I will say, this was a really good movie. American Gangster, and that article, of course, was a really good article as well. But American Gangster was a really good movie. And I like that they made him seem so much more human in the movie versus, you know, when you read about his crimes, you know, you paint him out as this monster. Then when you see him in a movie, you're like, okay, he had a lot of heart to him. You know, he had a heart. So, yeah, that was a pretty good movie. One of my favorite books, The Color Purple. It was directed in 1985 by Steven Spielberg, and it was based on the 1982 Pulitzer Prize-winning novel by Alice Walker. The story of Celia, a young girl who's living in, you know, 1930s and 40s Georgia, who's married off to a much older man when she's only 14 years old, and it's her story. Now, I have a review coming up about this book, so I don't want to give away too much of this, but they did a really good job of telling this story. Now, of course, they left out more of what happened to each character in the movie that was in the book, but overall, I really think they did justice to this movie. They also made a play about it, which put more of the book into the in the play. But I never got a chance to see the play. Hopefully, I get to see it soon. It's on my 30 before 30 list, so hopefully, I get to see it one day. But yeah, they did a really good job of being true to that story. They didn't change Celia too much. They didn't change Mr. too much. But I do want to say, I wish they would have put, they would have put more of Mr.'s and Celia's relationship in the movie. But overall, I'm not mad about it. But I'll tell you about that more in a coming video about The Color Purple. All right. 1994 is The Shawshank Redemption, which was based on a novella in this book that Stephen King published called Different Seasons. And the actual novella is called Rita Hayworth and The Shawshank Redemption. And it was published in 1982. Like I said, by Stephen King. And they did a really good job of staying true to that story. And one thing that I love about The Shawshank Redemption that they changed in the movie, but it was perfectly okay, was that in the book, Red was a white Irish man. Red is Morgan Freeman's character. He was a white Irish man. And in the book, they made him black, you know, with the red skin tone. But that was totally fine. It was totally fine. And I do like that in the movie, spoiler alert, I'm sorry if you have never read the book or seen the movie. In the movie, it was a lot more emotional because they killed the Tommy character in the movie versus in the book, he was transferred out of the prison. But even still, like, the movie was so good. Like, I saw the movie growing up and I read the book in high school, well, the novella in high school. And that's when I learned it was actually a short story. And I was like, oh my God, a short story out of this. Which leads me into Stand By Me. 1986 is Stand By Me featuring River Phoenix. I can't remember everybody else now, but I can remember River Phoenix was in it. It's also based in that same novella that I just talked about, Different Seasons by Stephen King. And it was it wasn't called Stand By Me. The book was called The Body. Yeah, The Body. And it was just, you know, just like the movie, these boys go off on a trek to find this this dead boy's body after one of the friends heard their bigger brother talking about it, they came up on the body. But yeah, they did a really good job of staying true to the story in that as well. And you know, one thing I like about Stephen King is that he doesn't mind killing his characters. But he kind of killed them in a noble way. And like, not so much as his horror stories, of course, but his more heartfelt novels, he kills them in a more noble way. So I like that. You know how like John Coffey and the Green Mile died in the electric chair, but it was something that he wanted. And then Stand By Me, the movie, and in the book, The Body, the guy Chris, he died, you know, being a noble character, trying to defend, trying to break up a fight. So that was really good. Okay, and To Kill a Mockingbird, 1962's To Kill a Mockingbird. I can't remember who all starred in that, but I think Brock Peters was the man on trial as being accused of raping the young girl. And you know what? I was very happy with this. I grew up, of course, watching and reading both To Kill a Mockingbird. I saw the movie before I read the book because, you know, grew up watching movies all the time. So I saw the movie before I actually read the book, and I read the book in elementary school, and it was a really good book. And then I read it again in high school. Don't ask me why my teacher had those dissected into To Kill a Mockingbird, because I always felt like that was an elementary book, but I read it in 10th grade. that was a great adaptation of that book. I really like how they did that movie as well. 1994's Forrest Gump. 1994's Forrest Gump featuring Tom Hanks, which was based on the 1986 novel by Winston Groom. Now, this is the one I was telling you, they really changed the character from the source, but I was completely fine with it. So in the book, Forrest was kind of crass and a little brash, whereas in the movie, he was more, conservative, a southerner. You know, he was like he was much more of a good dude in the movie than he was in the book. Because, of course, like I said about To Kill a Mockingbird, I saw the movie growing up, and I read the book when I was in 9th grade. And I was like, this is nothing like the movie that... I was like, this is nothing like the Forrest that I know, that I grew up knowing. But it was still a good book. I really like how they did the movie, because I don't think Forrest Gump from the book would have been such a huge, impactful movie, you know, if they had used the guy from the book as they did, the way they softened his character out and fleshed him out a lot more. You know, they did a really good job with that. So, you know what I would say? It seemed like they gave all of Forrest Gump's more negative behavior to Jenny. So in the book, Forrest Gump was a little, like I said, he was real crass. So it seemed like they gave all his negative attributes from the book. In the movie, they gave them all to Jenny. That's what I'll say. But even still, it worked for me because I actually like Forrest Gump, the movie, a lot more than I like the book Forrest Gump. So it worked for me. Alrighty. Then we have 1995's Waiter to Exhale, which was based on a 1992 novel by Terry McMillan. Now, this book and the movie both were awesome. I ain't got no complaints at all. Like, they were so good. Like, just so good. Like, the movie featured, it was directed by Forrest Whitaker, and I believe Terry McMillan wrote the screenplay. And even still, she did a really good job. Yeah, I think she did. She did a really good job on the screenplay as well, because I know it has to be difficult to, you know, to chop up your own work for a movie, because I don't know how they do it. I'm like, no, have somebody else write it. I'm not going to chop up my works for this movie. I want everything that I wrote to be in the movie. That's what I be thinking. Waiting to Exhale, the movie, was a strong adaptation of the book. They did a really good job. They had Babyface on the music. Like, that score was everything. I think it was nominated for an Academy Award, but I'm not sure. And if it wasn't, shame on you, Academy Award, because Babyface did that on that soundtrack. And then, you know, everyone falls in love sometimes. Whitney Houston sung that song, shoot. So, and with that book, that was a movie that I watched growing up. Then I read the book, you know, when I was old enough to read the book, and I was like, okay, they did a really good job with this, because, you know, they did. Black excellence. 1998's Beloved. It was directed by Jonathan Demme. But Oprah Winfrey produced it. Now, let me say this. I have a video coming based on this book as well. But I'm going to say this. That movie, I don't believe, I think it only did like $50 million in theaters, but I really just don't think people understood it or wanted to understand it. That was a good movie. Like, Oprah Winfrey Studios did a thing with producing that movie. Like, it was so powerful. And I remember watching the book because it came out in 98, so I was 7. But I remember watching that movie, and I was scared because it was kind of like it dealt with the mysticism and a cult somewhat. But I remember being afraid that, you know, I remember just being afraid to like go sneak a piece of cake at night after I watched that movie, or to eat cake, because I would always be afraid that a baby's handprint would appear on that cake. But it was a really strong adaptation of that movie. Of course, they didn't put everything in that movie, but what they put in that movie deserved to be in that movie. Really deserved to be in that movie. They did a very good job of that movie. I can't say it enough. They did a really good job of that movie. I can't even say it enough. A really good job. Though, of course, like I said, they left out some words in. They left out some things that I feel like should have been in the movie. Such as, you know, that's going to be another video, so I ain't even going to go too deep on it, because I don't want this video to be too long. But they left out stuff that I feel like should have been in that movie. But even still, I think it was a great movie, and it definitely should have hit like at least $200 million in the theaters in the 90s, because that was a really good movie. The book was good, just all around good. Okay, Malcolm X came out in 1992. It was directed by Spike Lee, and it starred Denzel Washington, Angela Bassett, Spike Lee, of course. I think Roger Genevieve Smith, if that's how you pronounce his name. Juan Carlos Esposito. Him. He was in it. Who else was in it? Lynette McKee. Verified actress. That lady deserved all the flowers she can get. And it was based on the 1965 novel, The Autobiography of Malcolm X, which was written by Malcolm X and Alex Haley together. And it was very true to the source. It was actually true to real life, like a really true to life movie. And I really loved it. And one thing that I loved about The Autobiography of Malcolm X is that they actually showed him making his pilgrimage to Mecca. And I really like that they showed that in the actual movie to show that, you know, Malcolm X was really a Muslim. Like, I'm not dissing the Nation of Islam at all, because I don't want nobody to diss my religion. But I was saying, like, he really was a Muslim. Like, he made the pilgrimage to Mecca, you know, he and his whole family practiced it. It was really a powerful movie. And the book was good as well. I read the book, in high school, yeah, because I've always liked Malcolm X. I named one of my nephews after him, after his name that he changed it to, Malik. But yeah, they did a really good job of adapting that movie. Okay, and the last one is 2009's Precious by Lee Daniels. It was actually based on a book called Push by Sapphire. And you know what I'm going to say? They did a magnificent job with this movie. I'm not going to lie. They did a great job with that movie. Like, they did a really good job. And I'm going to actually say this. I'm glad they toned down the violence and the abuse, in the movie, because it was so much in the book. Like, reading the book, I remember reading the book in my ninth grade year, and I remember I was just like, by page 52, I stopped reading it for a few days because it was just too much to digest for my little 14-year-old mind, and I had to stop reading that book. So I'm really glad that they toned down the sexual abuse in that book, in a movie that was so rampant in the book. They really toned it down. So have to say that. So anyhow, that is my list of movies that were adapted from magazine articles and books for me. And now I'm going to say this as well. I honestly feel like movies should, I feel like if you're going to if you're going to make a book into a movie, I honestly feel like it should be like a two-part series. That's what I feel like, because I just feel like it's just always so much in the book that you can't put in the movie. You know, you can't condense it into a two-hour movie. So I always feel like you just should do a two-part series whenever you do whenever you're basing something on a movie. That's just my thoughts on it. However, I remember when I didn't really like the way Harry Potter the seventh book of Harry Potter, it deserved to have a two-part movie finale. But I don't feel like The Hunger Games or Bella, Twilight's Breaking Dawn, I don't feel like those books needed a two-part ending. But that's my opinion. But I really feel like when you're doing a movie, you should do like a little limited series on TV when you're doing a movie based on a book. Because The Color Purple, you know, even though I love the movie, I don't really have nothing negative to say about the movie. I really feel like it should have been a two-part series where they showed more Celia's life after she left Mr. Because they didn't really show Celia, like, living and breathing freely enough. And, which other one? Yeah, and they should have showed more of Denver, living after she left her parents, after she left her mom's house. Not, she didn't leave her mom, of course, and Beloved, that's what I'm talking about, Beloved. But they should have showed more of her, like, venturing out into the community than they did in the movie. And they could have did that with a limited series. So that's my take on it. But anyway, you drop down in the comments and let me know what you guys' movies that you love that were based on a book, or movies that you hated that was based on a book, which is also coming soon. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And you can also follow me on Instagram at BooksXBrit, as well as email me at BooksXBrit@gmail.com. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!